Knowledge of infiltration is important, for instance, when studying land degradation processes both at the surface and below. The photo to the left shows that if on a hill slope the precipitation intensity is larger than the infiltration rate into a soil, overland flow and gully erosion can occur. Too much water in the soil can cause mass movements. The photo to the right shows a hummocky appearance of a hill slope due to small mass movements, so-called soil creep. This short lecture introduces the green and Ampt equation for the infiltration of water from a ponded water layer at the soil surface. The standard rigorous approach for calculating infiltration into a soil is the Richards equation after the American soil physicist Lorenzo A. Richards. The Richards equation, shown here in its mixed form for the vertical z direction, is a difficult to solve nonlinear partial differential equation. Note that both the unsaturated hydraulic conductivity K psi and the total potential H on the left-hand side of the equation, as well as the volumetric moisture content theta on the right-hand side of the equation, are related to each other, which calls for some cumbersome trial and error problem solving. Because of this, simpler analytical approximations that can be physically and mathematically related to the Richards equation have been developed in the past for estimating ponded infiltration, which is the changing infiltration rate with time from a water layer ponded at the soil surface, thus when the rainfall intensity in millimeter per hour exceeds the infiltration rate in millimeter per hour. One of such equations is the Green and Ampt equation. This figure is a momentary view of the change in volumetric moisture content theta, the volume fraction or volume percentage of water-filled pores in a soil, with soil depth during ponded infiltration, infiltration from water ponded at the soil surface. The Australian scientists Green and Ampt developed a physical approximation model of ponded infiltration. Their key simplification is the assumption of a sharp wetting front. The initial volumetric moisture content in the soil, theta I, is taken as constant, and ponded infiltration evolves from a water layer with constant head H0. When we take the soil surface as reference level, Z is 0, then the wetting front has reached a depth Z is L, with L having a negative value. Because the soil above the wetting front is water saturated and the soil below the front still has its initial moisture content, there exists a high suction gradient at the wetting front. The matrix potential, negative pressure head with the existing air pressure as zero reference, in the dry soil below the wetting front is represented by Green and Ampt as psi f being a negative number. Green and Ampt applied both Bernoulli's law and Darcy's law as follows. The gravitational potential Z at the wetting front equals L. The matrix potential psi at the wetting front equals psi f. The total potential at the wetting front, therefore, equals L plus psi f. The elevation head or gravitational potential Z at the soil surface equals 0. The pressure head at the soil surface equals H0. The total potential or hydraulic head H at the soil surface thus equals 0 plus H0 is H0. The porous medium offering resistance to the infiltrating water flow stretches from the soil surface to the wetting front. And the difference in hydraulic head equals the total potential at the water receiving end minus the hydraulic head at the water dispatching end, which is L plus psi F minus H0. The distance covered is defined as the location to which water flows minus the location from where it is dispatched. Thus, L minus 0 is L. And the hydraulic gradient in Darcy's law for downward flow therefore equals L plus psi F minus H0 divided by L. Multiplying the hydraulic gradient with the saturated hydraulic conductivity K yields the downward specific discharge or volume flux density Q, the volumetric flow rate per unit area of porous media perpendicular to the flow, thus not a measure of the water's velocity. The flow is downwards, thus the specific discharge or volume flux density Q is a negative number. Psi F and L are also negative numbers. So, as just shown, you can easily derive the Green and Ampt equation by applying both Bernoulli's law and Darcy's law. In hydrological literature, the infiltration rate F, which is not a velocity but a specific discharge or volume flux density, as well as the distance from the surface to the wetting front L, are often taken to be positive. The infiltration rate F then is the positive value of the vertical specific discharge or vertical volume flux density Q. When we also replace the matrix potential at the wetting front psi F by the wetting front soil suction head SF, thus SF equals minus psi F, this yields the Green and Ampt equation for ponded infiltration as shown here. The Green and Ampt equation for ponded infiltration applies particularly to infiltration into uniform, initially dry, coarse textured soils that exhibit a sharp wetting front. Although the Green and Ampt equation is derived from a model, thus a simplification of reality, it provides important insights into the infiltration process, which can be verified by infiltration experiments, for instance, by using a double ring infiltrometer or rainfall simulator. First of all, from this equation, it is clear that as infiltration continues, T to infinity, L becomes larger and larger still, causing the hydraulic gradient and consequently the infiltration rate F to gradually decline during infiltration. Secondly, after quite some time has passed, L will be much larger than both SF and H0, and the hydraulic gradient indicated as lowercase I here will be reduced to a value of 1, causing the final infiltration rate to be equal to the saturated hydraulic conductivity K. This is called gravity drainage. This figure, after an infiltration experiment, shows the gradual decline with time of the infiltration rate F during ponded infiltration. Note the scatter of the measurements. This is not abnormal for ponded infiltration experiments. This figure and its derivation can be found as an interactive spreadsheet on the Online Resource Center or companion website of my textbook at Oxford University Press, together with two other descriptions of the ponded infiltration process. Those of Horton, Robert Horton, an American civil engineer and soil scientist, and Philip, John Philip, an Australian hydrologist and soil water physicist. All these equations show that when ponded infiltration lasts long enough, the final infiltration rate will be equal to the saturated hydraulic conductivity, as shown here.